Everyone, I am Nilofer Yasmin. This is Satellite and Radar Systems, and we're going to talk about Moving Target Indicator Radar, that is MTI. This is a lecture in continuation with the previous lecture, where we have discussed in detail what is a moving target indicator. As we all know, that radar is an acronym used for radio detection and ranging. So radar is a technology that we use to detect the presence of an object in our territory. Here the object is called as target. Detection means finding the presence of that object, and range calculation here means the distance of the target from the transmitting end, right? So the object or the target which is detected could be a stationary one, like the presence of hills or trees or sea in the vicinity, or it could be a moving target. In military applications and most of the applications, we always look for the target which is moving. So moving target indicator radar is a special kind of radar that separates it from stationary targets, right? So even this has its own way of working. It uses the phenomena of Doppler shift. Using and analyzing the Doppler frequency shift, it rejects the received signals because of the stationary components present in the vicinity and only gives a response for the non-stationary object, right? Here, the stationary objects present in the vicinity are called as clutter. These all things have been discussed previously. Although MTI radar, as it works using the phenomena of Doppler frequency shift, it has its own limitations. And one of the prime limitation in case of moving target indicator is my blind speed. So we'll start from blind speed again, although it has been discussed, I give a brief review of it. Then we talk about digital signal processes, that is how MTI radar actually works. Then we talk in detail about MTI. MTI radar processor, detail of it. Then we talk about pulse Doppler radar. And finally, pulse radar. And we're going to compare MTI with pulse Doppler radar. So what is blind speed? We know it is the radial speed of the airplane at which phase shifting of echo signal has a value, which is plus minus, and that is 360 degree between the two pulse periods. With blind speeds, moving targets are suppressed by a MTI system like ground clutters. We know when the frequency response like this is obtained, these are the points of zero energy, right? If a target appears at this point of time, it cannot be detected by my system, right? So to avoid it, we use different phenomena. What are those various phenomena? We're going to talk about it. So if a target is approaching us, but it will be misunderstood by the ground clutters, because at this point, we consider there is no AC component, there is just the DC component. And DC component could possibly be arising because of the stationary objects in the vicinity. Those stationary objects are called as clutters, like sea, tree, mountains, hills, etc. So a target which is approaching to us with that speed, which is not detected by our system, the velocity of that target will be called as the blind speed, right? This occurs at every integral multiple of pi, right? There are various ways of removing blind speed or decreasing blind speed. These are using coherence channel only if it is necessary, right? It has a better maximum range, or constantly changing the frequency diversity, right? Although it requires a large frequency spacing and bandwidth, right? Another way is to constantly change the pulse repetition frequency. And if we change that pulse repetition frequency at every pulse, that will be the best scenario. So changing the pulse after every pulse is called as staggered pulse repetition frequency, right? So that is staggered PRT, that is pulse repetition time, right? Every pulse will be transmitted with some different frequency. However, all these measures are already part of my standard air surveillance radar sets, right? So we know that there are so many limitations to MTI radar. So let's study MTI radar in little detail. How the signal processor actually works, where is the memory element, how do we actually differentiate our signals, echo signals from the stationary target. In radar system, MTI signal processing is to be done in the receiver, which is true. Here, the received echo signals either from the target or from the clutter are to be processed in such a manner that the display unit only moving targets to be available. That means whenever signal is transmitted, we are expecting that it will be reflected back by a moving target. Whereas in the vicinity, if there is a tree and my signal is reflected back from it, my system must be wise enough to differentiate between these two echo, right? Echo 1 and echo 2. Echo 1 here will be because of the moving target, echo 2 will be because of the stationary target. So it must be intelligent enough to differentiate these two echoes. This will be called as clutter, right? So my display unit should be displaying only the echoes because of the moving target. Now we have digital techniques that allowed radar designers to use memory as a digital storage device, right? In that, delay can be obtained for whatever time, length of time was required, right? So we need a good processor that will analyze these two signals, process them, will have some storage unit, will have some reference data, will use phase locking, comparison, and filtering out. So all these things have to undergo within the system. So we need a good digital signal processor here. So the advantages which are offered by my MTI processor, it includes removal of blind speed, blind phase in MTI radar by using in phase and quadrant channel. Now, as we have seen, blind speed is a major issue in case of my MTI radar. Now we have to think of ways to remove it, to eliminate it or to reduce it. So we can use good quality of digital signal processor, right? Even the complete block can be replaced with two channels consisting of my in-phase channel and quadrant channel. Whenever we use, we combine the output of these in-phase and quadrant channel, we get, we are able to eliminate most of the noise, right? Here the noise is the echo signal from the stationary targets. Let's see how my digital signal processor works. So here, instead of using a single receiver that we in most of the radar receiver we use, that is a separate super heterodyne receiver that usually consists of my low noise amplifier, then the mixer, then we use the IF amplifier stage, then we go for actual demodulation or detection. And in case of MTI radar, most of the time we do use a my phase detection technique, because there will be no phase change in case of my stationary target. So one thing that is important here, phase shift, phase detection. Of course, we use this phase detection here as well, but using two channels, that is my in-phase channel and quadrator channel, will help me reduce blind speed to much more extent. Let's see how it works. After the IF stage, instead of using a single phase demodulator, we use two channels, that is in-phase and quadrature channel. This is my in-phase channel. Here I use a phase detector, a sample and hold circuit, right? After sample and hold, I know that my analog signal, we are moving towards discretization, right? What does sampling mean? Sampling will convert a continuous time domain signal into discrete time domain signal, right? We discretize a continuous time, continuous amplitude signal into discrete time, continuous and amplitude signal with the help of sampling. we are approaching towards digitization, right? What signal is received is my analog signal. I need to convert it into digital first so that I can apply the digital processing here. And after applying digital processing and removing the clutter, I can again convert back my signal into analog. So I use A to D converter first. I use digital signal processing. The complete unit is here. And finally, before displaying it, right? Because that has to be displayed in the original form. It is again converted back into analog form, right? So I have this digital storage. So phase detection ke liye, for phase detection, I need first what I do is sample and hold. That is, sample and hold will generate my pulse train, right? After sampling and holding, A to D conversion, that will of course will be having a quantizer within it. That depends on what kind of quantizer we use based on what frequency we are receiving, right? Then I do have a memory element, which is my digital storage, right? I have the subtractor unit, right? Same thing happens here. But as we know, to phase detector, one of the input is my from IF. Another input is my coherent wave, which is generated with the help of a oscillator here. So which is represented by coho. This goes as it is to in-phase channel, whereas this goes with 90 degree phase shift to my quadrator channel, right? It goes to the phase detector, then to sample and hold circuit, and to analog to digital converter. Same thing happens here. It is stored, subtracted, and we take only the magnitude part of these two. After subtraction, when we consider only the magnitude part, and finally it is again converted from digital to analog manner. And after converting it to analog manner, we display it using our displaying device, right? So all that has been explained here in the theory, what I have explained just now. Like the learners can go through the slides. Output from the IF amplifier is split into two channels, I and Q. Output of these detectors are 90 degree out of phase. These are converted into A to D. Then we only consider the magnitude, which will be the square root of I square plus Q square. This is square, right? Now, on this principle, what kind of radar we do have? We do have example of MTI radar processor. This is an MTI radar processor which specifically uses 8 pulse Doppler filter bank. Instead of using a simple filter, a single filter, we use bank of 8 filters, right? This is going to make the process a little complex, but we are going to get accurate data, right? Here, we reduce the chances of clutter, we reduce the chances of misunderstanding some stationary target with the moving target. We misunderstood, we reduce the chances of getting blind speed. So using Doppler bank of filters instead of a single filter is always useful, right? I channel, Q channel, both the output, these are sent to a 3 pulse concealer. Then I process it through a filter bank. Weighing and magnitude, thresholding, I do have a zero velocity filter here, its magnitude is observed. Then clutter map, recursive filter I have a memory element. All these works on the phenomenon of my digital signal processing. And using thresholding, I generate report here, which is called as hint report, right? So this helps me. So we are moving towards accuracy. For moving target detection, this is an advanced version of MTI, right? This was developed by MIT Lincoln Laboratory for airport surveillance radars, ASRs. These processors are an advanced version of my MTI, right? These are for increased detection of moving target in clutter. If there is so much of clutter in the vicinity, then instead of using a simple MTI radar processor, we'll go with MTT, that is moving target indication. They do have some advanced things within them, like the 8 pulse Doppler filter bank, right? It would so a system which after this in phase and quadrator channel, if I apply this filter bank, then in presence of more of the noise as well, I'll get better output. So in those practical scenarios where more of the clutter is present, we use MTD instead of MTI, right? It produces, this much of improvement is observed here. It eliminates a large amount of the clutter that has a low false detection rate, right? Its output can be reliably remote via narrow bandwidth telephone circuits. So this is so good. If I talk about pulse Doppler radar, then it'll have a duplexer, a transmitter, locking mixer, coherent frequency which is generated. Stello here is the locally generated frequency by the local oscillator. This is the receiver mixer, IF amplifier, phase detector, and digital signal processing we apply here. How it works? A pulse Doppler radar is a combination of pulse radar and continuous wave radar, right? So it works, this is my pulse Doppler radar, right? Pulse Doppler radar. It is a combination of my pulse radar and CW radar. It works on the principle of my Doppler shift as MTI radar follows, right? It analyzes if there, I transmit a frequency F, I receive F dash. If there is a change in frequency, that means my target is moving. By analyzing that frequency, we actually detect, we get to know that whether the target is approaching us or moving away. As per the Nyquist criteria, the sampling rate should be greater than or equal to twice the Doppler shift frequency. But in MTI, due to low frequency, it's become undersampled. True? So it will lead to ambiguous estimation of target speed and occurrence of blind speed. True, where target appears as stationary and unresolvable against background clutter, right? So what do we do in such case? Pulse Doppler radar, it uses high PRF. So it can remove the Doppler ambiguities. So whenever we use Doppler frequency shift as a background phenomena, there is always chances of ambiguous estimation, occurrence of blind speed, which can be reduced in my pulse Doppler radar. To extract the Doppler shift information of the carrier, the pulse radar should be modified by introducing a coherent oscillator. Here, we use a coherent oscillator for frequency stability in the transmitter and receiver chain. So it employs the coherent radar system. I do have this. What is the difference between my pulse Doppler radar and MTI radar? Both radar basically depends on same frequency, which is my Doppler frequency shift. But the major difference is MTI radar has no range ambiguity, while range ambiguity may occur in pulse Doppler, right? Improvement factor need not to be improved in MTI radar, where improvement factor is needed in pulse Doppler. As we have earlier studied what is pulse radar, what is CW radar, MTI is a advancement over it, right? Usually, instead of using magnetron, we start using power klystron here, right? MTI radar uses analog delay line canceller, while in pulse radar, it uses analog filter banks, right? MTI radar receives less clutter signal, while pulse Doppler radar receives more clutter signal. So these are some differences. It is used in this pulse Doppler radar is used in weather warning radar as air bases to detect, measure thunderstorm, turbulence, useful in detecting and estimating the target motion, locking of particular target. So these are the application, thunderstorm, rain, mostly in weather. If I talk about advantages of my pulse Doppler radar, it has got the ability to reject unwanted echoes by Doppler filters or by range gating. So this is also useful. It can measure the range and velocity over predetermined limits, even in case of multiple target, right? Signal to noise ratio can be increased by using coherent integration. We use coho here, which is very useful. So that's it for today. These are the references which I have used. Thank you.